Deep brain stimulation is like a pacemaker for the brain. It provides a small amount of electricity to correct for the abnormal brain activity present in patients with Parkinson's disease, essential tremor, or dystonia. Patients are implanted with deep brain stimulation devices by a neurosurgeon such as myself, but they work closely with their neurologist to find the best settings for treatment. The main two parts of a deep brain stimulation system include the thin wires that go into the brain and the battery that is located underneath the skin in the chest area below the clavicle. For patients with Parkinson's disease and essential tremor, the deep brain stimulation therapy is effective immediately when the battery is turned on. For patients with dystonia, however, it takes several weeks for the therapy to become effective. Focused ultrasound and other lesion-based procedures are permanent. On the other hand, deep brain stimulation systems can be adjusted to achieve maximal benefit with minimal side effects. For patients who desire their therapy to be turned off, that can be done very easily with a wireless controller. For patients who desire that the device be taken out entirely, that can be done as well with a relatively straightforward procedure. There are two types of batteries for deep brain stimulation systems. There are non-rechargeable batteries and rechargeable batteries. Non-rechargeable batteries tend to last on average of 4 years. After the battery is depleted, it needs to be replaced in an outpatient procedure, and that's typically 1 hour, and patients can go home the same day of the procedure. On the other hand, rechargeable batteries can last up to 15 years. Those do require recharging with a scarf-like device that's worn by the patient.